Hello everyone. In this video, I'll show how to create dashboard with menu blur background, and create JDesktopPane with internal frame to show form when user click on the menu, and we build this project with FlatLaf look and feel. Now create new project in IntelliJ. And we add Maven dependency here. So we using swing blur background, this project I have public on my GitHub, so we can get the jar file here. And we using GlassPane popup library, so we can get the jar file in this folder. We using this library to create the menu, so we can check the release here. The menu drawer have adds since version 1.1. And in version 1.4 it support dynamic submenu item, so now we install the latest version to get all features update. Now go to project folder and create new library folder. Copy jar file to here, and go to add the Maven to the project. Just copy this code. And we need add another library that use in this project. Next go to add the GlassPane popup, copy this. And for this library FlatLaf we have add already, so we need copy only MIG layout here. And we need use the FlatLaf font Roboto, so we can go to copy Maven from this project. And we remove the test scope here. Then click on this button to load the Maven file. So after set up the project library, next we going to create the JFrame form. Create new package as application. And in this package create new class as application. Extends this class from JFrame. Then create main method. So first we need install the Roboto font. Then set up the FlatLaf look and feel, so we using Mac dark themes. And then show this JFrame. Here create new init method. And we need config this JFrame here. First set the default close operation. And set the JFrame size. Then set location relative to null, to make frame show center of the screen. Now we can run it. Here we got the empty frame. So next we going to set up the background image. To use the background image with blur style, we are using this library that we have installed, so we can check the sample code here. So go to create the new class. First create new package as components. Then create main form class. Extends this class from blur background. Create default constructor and init method. And we need the image file for the background, so add new folder in project resources folder. Here we have background image and profile image, now copy it to the resources folder. Then in this main form, create the image icon object for the background. Use method setImage, and call method getImage from icon object. Then go to application class, create the main form object here. And add this main form to the frame content pane. Now run it. Here we got the frame with background image. Let go to the FlatLaf, we have the new update. We can enable the full window content mode in window decorations. Just copy this to the frame. We need remove this, and we need to import the flat client properties. Now run it. Here we got full windows. For this blur background, we can use the overlay style. We have two parameter, color and opacity. So next we're going to create the menu, by create new class as system menu. For this class we want the blur background, so extends this class from blur child. Create default constructor and init method. So first we apply style to this menu, by call super constructor with the style. For blur, use method set blur, so we use 30. And we set the border, new with the style border. We use 10 as the border radius. In border style we can set the border opacity. And set border width. And border color, for border color we can use the gradient color. For gradient color parameter we have, start color and color, start point and end point. So the end point we use x1 and y0, x1 for 100% width. After set border style we can set the overlay style. So next we go to add this menu to the main form, just go to main form and create the system menu object here. Then set layout to this main form, so we use MIG layout. Initialize the system menu object, then add it to this main panel. We can use MIG layout constraints doc west, to make the menu location at the left side, and we set the menu gap all 6, and for the menu width we set fixed 280. And for this MIG layout we use fill layout, and also fill for the column and row. Now we can run it. So we have the blur menu here. Next we're going to create the menu item, so go to system menu class. Create the simple menu object here, that this class use from the glass pane pop-up library. And initialize this object here, so we need the simple menu option. Just create new method to get the menu option here. Then add this simple menu object to this blur child. And we need to set the layout to this blur child, so we also use MIG layout. We use wrap, because we need only one column as the layout. Then we create the menu item here. Here I have the menu SVG icon, so copy this folder to the project resources. And I have sample code to create menu item. We need import this from drawer menu package. Then set this menu item to the menu option. Now we can run it. Here we have the menu, but error with icon, because we not yet set the icon path. But for this menu we need remove the background by set opaque to false. Then set the base icon path to the menu option. And we scale icon to 0.5. Now run it. But we see the button item still have the background color, so we need remove all the background. In this menu option we can set the button style and submenu panel style. Use method set menu style, and we need override two method, style menu panel and style menu item. Set opaque false to the panel. And for button we set content area filled to false. Now run it. Here we get the menu with blur background, but it not have the scroll bar, so we need add the scroll pane to the menu. Create J scroll pane here. Put this simple menu object into this scroll pane. For this scroll pane we also need to remove the background and border. For border we set to empty border, and set opaque to false to remove background. And also remove the background to the viewport in scroll pane. And remove vertical scroll bar background. And set unit increment to 10. Then we add FlatLaf style to scroll bar. Here change this to scroll pane. Now run it. Here we see the scroll bar now, so next we going to create the menu header. For header menu, we can use the simple header in the glass pane pop-up library like the simple menu. And this header need the simple header data, so create new method that return the header data. Here we can set the title. Header description. And icon. For icon we can use avatar icon, that is icon also used from the glasspane pop-up library. We set icon width and height is 60, and for the round border use 999, so it will be the circle. Then add this header data to the header object. And we also need remove the background for this header. Then add this header to this menu. But for the profile image we using PNG not JPG, so we need change it. Now run it. But we see the header panel has resized to the menu height. Go to MIG layout. We need add grow 0 to the first row. Now run it again. Here now we get the menu with the blur image background. And next we add event menu selected item to this menu. So we can add event here, by call method add menu event. But for this event we will implement next, after we create the desktop pane for show the form, and if you click the menu this output code will work. And next we going to create the title, so create new class as title. We also extends this class from blur child. And create default constructor. Then create new style by call super constructor. But for title style we can copy from the menu style. So copy this code here. So next we going to add this title to the main form, by go to main form and create title object here. Initialize this title object, and add it into this main form. And we use MIG layout constraints doc north, to set this title to the top, and set gap to this title. And for height use fixed 50. Now run it. Here we get the title, but no any component or button action in this title. Here in this title class we can create new init method. So if you want add any component you can implements here. So next we going to create the J desktop pane. Go to main form class and create new J desktop pane object. Initialize this object here. And set layout to null, because we enable user to move the internal frame into this desktop pane. Then set opaque to false to remove background. And add this desktop pane to this main form. Then go the system menu class, so when we click on the menu item, we need add new form into this desktop pane. But in this system menu class we cannot access the desktop pane object, so we need create the new class to store the desktop pane as global. So create new class as form manager, and create static instance. And create method get this instance as public static. So if this instance is null, we need initialize to this instance, then return this instance. And create private constructor, so this is we call the singleton class. So now we can create the desktop pane object here. And create method set to this object. And create method to show the form, we have form title and component object. In this method we create the JInternalFrame object. And set title and option for this internal frame. So we can check the internal frame constructor parameter here. Its title, resizable, closable, maximizable and iconifiable. So here we set all true, to enable all option. Then set size to this frame. And add component into this internal frame. And then set visible true. So now we can add this internal frame to the desktop pane. And we add to the first index, because we want show the last frame on the top. So now we can call the show form method to add the component to the desktop pane. Here now go to the menu event, and we check the menu selected index here. Here we can add new J label for test, but you can create another form to add into this. So this is the title, and this the component will add into desktop pane with internal frame. But we need go to the main form to set this desktop pane object to the desktop pane in form manager. Now we can run it. Here we get the frame and we can move it. And we can add more form. But for desktop pane we need gap at the bottom and right, so we can set it by go to main form class, and set the MIG layout insets here. And thank you everyone for watching, see you next video.